I welcome you all to the last part of pointers and structures. Now we are going to store the address of a structure in a pointer variable, and we are going to learn how we are going to the structure members using the pointer variable. And particularly the operator is called as arrow operator, otherwise called as member selection operator. Using this operator, we are going to access the structure members. It's a recall. Whenever we want to access a structure member, we use dot operator to access the members of a structure. Structure variable together with dot operator, we can access the, but here pointer variable together with arrow operator, otherwise called as member selection operator, can be used to access the structure members. Then finally, linking structure pointer of a structure to a function. How we are going to send the address of a structure to a function and how we are going to access that one. These are the three points. First one, I'm going to explain you how to declare a structure variable as a pointer. Then I'm going to explain how we are going to access the structure members using the pointer. Then finally, how we are going to send the address of a structure to a function and how to access the structure members in function. Consider this example. This is an example for a structure inventory. It contains name, number, price. Name of item, number of items available, and price of a single item. These two are structure variables and these are all structure members. I want to access structure members, that is name, number, price, using the structure variables product and the pointer variable PTR. This is an array. The structure variable is an array containing two elements. Now, I want to store the address of this structure variable in this pointer. That can be easily done by PTR equal to product. Since it is an array, the name of an array itself contains the base address of the array. So, I can simply assign the base address of this array as PTR equal to product. This simply assigns the address of the product 0. If I write PTR plus 1, the increment will be made to the pointer P. The pointer P contains the address of product. Whenever I make an increment, it passes on to the next record, not the next address. It passes to the next record, that is product of 1. This is the way to declare a pointer variable, that is a pointer variable as a structure variable, and to collect the address of a structure variable in a pointer. Then, how can I access these members using this PTR? We know that I can access these members using structure variable product, using a dot product. Product of 1 dot name gives me name of the first product. Product 1 dot number gives me number of items available in product 1. Product 1 dot price gives me the price of first product. This is accessing these members using structure variable. Now I am going to access these members using pointer variable, in which the address of product 0 is assigned. Now for this we are going to use an operator called as member selection operator, otherwise called as arrow operator. This symbol is coined by a minus sign and with a greater than symbol. Now my variable is, pointer variable is PTR. PTR, instead of dot, you have to put your arrow mark name. PTR, arrow mark, arrow operator number. PTR, arrow operator price. This is the way to access the structure members using pointer. That is an example. This is an example which illustrates how to access. So I am going to read the values for these three structure members using a pointer variable, and I am going to print all the values using once again structure pointer. Okay, look at the structure invent. It contains name declared as a pointer, number, price. Coming to void main, struct is a keyword instructing the compiler that the following is a structure variable belonging to the structure called invent product of 3. It's an array containing 3 elements, 3 records of name, number, price and a pointer variable belonging to invent. Invent is a structure. Now we print f within double quotes input /in/in. So input will be printed and 2 new lines will be printed. So in the screen you will be having input. Then I am opening a for loop. Since it's an array, I have to read all the 3 products, product of their name, number, price for all the 3 products. So I am opening a loop. My loop starts with the first element. First element, the address is stored in product. So that product, the address of the first element, product of 0, is assigned to PTR. And this loop should exist until the third product gets over. That is product of 0, product of 1, product of 2. So I can move up to product of 2. So PTR less than, not equal to, less than product plus 3. Product plus 3 is the increment to the product, the address. Address will be incremented by 1. Then PTR plus. Then scanf. What we are going to read? We are going to read a name, number, price. So S, D, F, percentage F, percentage D, percentage F, indicating name, number, price. Since name is a string, there is no need for ampersand. So ampersand PTR, as usual, ampersand PTR, arrow operator, number, ampersand PTR, arrow operator, price. So for the first product, PTR contains the address of product 0. Now increment will be made, all the first 3 products will be read and in PTR will be incremented. What is PTR plus plus? It goes to the next record, that is PTR of 1. PTR of 1, the address compared with PTR plus product plus 3, that is base address plus 3. Then the condition is will be true here. Then it gets into the second to read the second product. Second product name, second product number, second product price. All of them will be read from keyboard since it's a scanf statement. Then once again, pointer will be incremented. Whenever a pointer is incremented, it move on to the next record, that is the third record. That is product of 0, product of 1 got over, now it is product of 2. So it checks the address of product of 2 and product of plus 3. Automatically it will be less than. So it gets into the loop, it read all the 3 values for product 3 and PTR will be incremented. Now it becomes product third address. I will be getting fourth address, which will be less than, which will not be less than this. So the condition will be false. It comes out. Now I have read all the 3 values, so I have to print all the 3. So output, so I am just for readability, I am writing print of output. Now initializing, now the PTR points to the last element. So I am once again moving from first point. So I am assigning PTR equal to product. Product means product of 0. The base address will be pointed to PTR. Instead of for loop, this time I am using while. Or else you can use the same for loop for printing. Instead of scanf, you can use printf. But here we are using while. What's the test condition? PTR should be the same test condition. PTR should be less than product plus 3. These increments should be kept inside while loop. This initialization is made at the beginning. All of them are same thing, but they have been done at the different places since it is a while loop. So initialization is made before starting the while loop. Test condition is here. Once again, printf, percentage s, name. What is this operator? Arrow operator, PTR, arrow name, PTR, arrow number, PTR, arrow price. There is no need for ampersand symbol because it is a printf statement. This 5D represents 5 spaces for this number, 10.2, 10 decimal places and 2, 10 integer part and 2 decimal part, fractional part will be allocated for the last one. So after printing all the 3, that is for product of 0, all the 3 will be printed. That is next PTR will be incremented. So next record, product of 1. Product of 1 is less than product plus 3. So it prints the second product. once again incremented, product of 2 less than product of 3, once again third product will be incremented, then the condition will be false, it comes out of the loop. The output will be like this. Input, my output will be looking like input. So first case input, I have to read all the 3. So I am giving the data, Nokia space 5 items, cost price 7500, Samsung 10 pieces 225,000. So these are all data about cell phones. So I am reading the data and I am printing this data. When this while loop is executed, this output will be printed like this. Since I have mentioned as 2 decimal place, the value will be printed in this way. That's all about accessing of structure members using a pointer variable. Finally, the last one, sending a structure to a function. Look at this example. This function name is print-invent. This is a function whose argument is a structure variable, which is a pointer. So structure, the name of the structure is invent. It is receiving address of a structure variable, so it is a pointer variable, star item. Now address of a structure variable passed to item. Now this is a pointer. So how to access item, arrow mark name, item arrow symbol price, in order to print the name and price. If you want to print the number, you can use item arrow mark number. So the same criteria, but I can also pass the address of a structure to a function. But look at here, if it is a structure variable, I have to write the keyword struct and name of the structure variable invent, and here it's a pointer variable. Since I am receiving the address, so it should be a pointer variable with the star item. How I have to invoke, how I have to call this function, I have to call print hyphen invent. I have to send the address. Address will be sent by ampersand. What is the structure variable name? Product. Product of 0. Ampersand product, where simply product means it is base address. Base address will be sent to this. So, simply, why I am sending a pointer instead of a structure variable? I can pass a structure variable, no? If I pass a structure variable, it requires a lot of memory space, as well as the speed of the execution will be little bit slower when compared to sending of your pointer. When you send a pointer, the speed will be higher, you can use less memory space. So these are the advantages of sending your address of a structure variable to your function. There are few more hints. Look at the example. It's a structure int count float star p. It's a pointer variable and this is a pointer structure variable ptr. How to access these elements using this ptr? By a increment variable, increment plus plus ptr arrow operator count. What is the meaning of this plus plus ptr? It increments the count, not the ptr. When you put plus plus ptr arrow count, it increments count, not the ptr. You should not mean that it is an increment for ptr. Suppose the same thing is written within brackets. In this case, ptr will be incremented and it will links the count. This count will be linked after incrementing ptr. Ptr, the address will be incremented and then it move on to that particular count. Star ptr arrow mark p, that means whenever you put dereferencing operator, it reads whatever p points to, because p is a pointer variable. So it reads the content in the address stored in p. Whatever the address stored in p, it takes that address and goes there and reads the value stored in the address of p. Not address of p, the address stored in p. Whatever address is stored in p is collected by ptr and it goes to that address and reads the value, not the address. Okay. Next one, star ptr arrow mark p plus plus. What happens here? It goes to the address that p points to. After that, it increments p. First it move on to the address stored in p. Whatever the address given in p, it took that address and goes to that point and reads that value, then it increments p. After that, it increments p. Next, star ptr rmr p within brackets plus plus. Here what happens, it goes to p, it increments whatever p points to. The value of p, the address stored in p is a pointer variable, so it collects the address stored in p, it goes to that place and it gets the value stored in that particular address and increments that value in that address. Suppose p is a pointer variable having some address, what happens in this case? This ptr collects the address of p and goes to that place, and suppose the value is 10, that value will be incremented by 1. 10 plus 1, that's what happened when this statement is executed. This next statement, star ptr plus plus arrow operator p. Here what happens, ptr goes to the value whatever p points to and then it increments, it increments ptr, it accesses that value, then it increments its address. These are the some concepts to be known while writing the program. So that's all about structures and pointers, and that's all about pointers too. We will join in files in C.